बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम डियर स्टूडेंट वेलकम टू दिस क्लास ऑफ कैलकुलस एंड एनालिटिकल ज्योमेट्री दैट इज़ द फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर कोर्स. नाउ टुडे वी डिस्कस द टेलर सीरीज, टेलर एंड मैकलॉरिन सीरीज. अकॉर्डिंग टू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ टेलर सीरीज इज हाउ टू डिफाइन टेलर सीरीज इज द फंक्शन एंड इट्स डेरिवेटिव टिल द इनफाइनाइट सम as well as to predict the possible values. It is Taylor series is the function and its derivative till the infinite sum. Okay, now according to the Taylor series, if we find the function sum n tends to 0 to infinity f of x is equals to function at 0 plus first derivative of the function at 0 time of x divided by 1 factorial plus double derivative of the function till x square divided by 2 factorial and so on till infinity. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
The Taylor series is what? It is the sum of the function and its possible derivative till infinite sum, that is equals to the function, to make the better prediction as possible. Okay, it is used to make the prediction as good as possible. Okay, which means Taylor series is specifically used for the better prediction as well as their immediate values. Now let's suppose if we can elaborate it by some example. Kindly note it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, now let's see some example how the Taylor series should apply to find the better prediction. If we have a function f of x is equals to 1 divided by 1 minus x. Now what is this? It is exponential function. If we transform it, the function should be power 1 shifted in numerator is become 1 minus x power minus 1. What is the type? It is a type of power function. Now according to the Taylor series, if we want to make prediction, then we have to take what? We have to take it in a three steps. In first step, we have to find the function at their nearest values. For example, if the function is f of x, then only one thing that is known to the function is that is the near to zero. The function is across to the zero, that is this point. We don't know where to the function is started and where it goes. Either it is increasing function, either it is decreasing, we don't know. Either it is static, we just one thing is known regarding this function is the function crosses across to the zero function. That is the origin.
Yes,
on the basis of this origin, this known values, we can predict the best possible values for the function, that is a power series. Now, first step, we have to find the function across the zero as well as all the possible derivatives till infinity, that is possible to show off the pattern recognition. Now, if we start by the solution, the function, first step, step one, we have to find the function f of x that is equals to 1 divided by 1 minus x. Now, the second is we have to find the first derivative. First derivative of this function is f prime of x is equals to, if we shift this function to the 1 minus x power minus 1, what happened? According to the derivative, the power function power become base,
yes,
and
sir.
One reduction exists onto their power. Like this, minus 1, 1 minus x power minus 1 and minus 1. Now we have to take the derivative as well of the original function, that is 1 minus x. 1 minus x. Now, minus 1. 1 minus x power minus 1 minus 1 minus 2, derivative of constant is 0 and derivative of x is minus 1. Now finally it's become minus minus plus, 1 ones are 1, into 1 minus x power minus 2. That is the first derivative of the function. Okay? Yes. Similarly, we have to find the second derivative of the function. What happened if we find the second derivative? In second derivative, the power become base. One reduction into their power. Again, whenever we take the derivative of the their original function, 1 becomes 0 and minus x become minus 1. And minus 1 multiply by their minus become plus. Let's see. If we find the second derivative of the function. Second derivative of this function is 1 power become base minus 2 time of 1 into 1 minus x power minus 2 minus 1 minus 3, but we have to take the derivative of function 1 minus x. Now what is this? Minus 2 time of 1, 1 minus x power minus 3, and derivative of constant 0 and x is minus 1. Now this minus 1 multiply by minus 1 become plus. Now what is this? This shows the pattern. In first derivative the function is 1. In second derivative function is 2 times 1. In third derivative function become 3 times 2 times 1. That shows the pattern. And by this process we have to predict the approximate value. Okay? Simplify this function. Minus minus plus 2 times 1 x power 1 minus x power minus 3. It is the second derivative of x. Now if we see the pattern, if it is the second prime, 2 times 1 and 1 minus x power, and 1 minus x is what? That is the original base function, and their power is 1 higher than their derivative. If derivative is 2, then power is 3 with minus sign. If derivative is 1, then that is 1 time of the original function, power 1 larger than their derivative with minus. Okay, if we take the third derivative of the function, what happened? Power become base. Minus 3 times 2 times 1, 1 minus x power, minus 3 minus 1 minus 4, and derivative of the 1 is 0, minus x become 1. Now this minus again multiply by minus 3 to produce plus. Now see, minus minus plus, 3 times 2 times 1, 1 minus x power minus 4. Is it clear?
Yes.
Either you have to find the next value directly. What will be the fourth derivative? The fourth derivative directly calculated by the process. If the derivative is 3, 3, 2, 1, that is the decreasing series till 1. It is what? It is the factorial. 3 into 2 into 1, 3 factorial. 2 into 1, 2 factorial. 1, the first derivative, 1 factorial. And if it is the fourth derivative, which means it is 4 factorial. 4 times 3 times 2 into 1 and 1 minus x power, the derivative is 4, which means the power is 5. 1 larger with negative sign. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
If we can process it till infinity, what will be the last term? That is the nth derivative. Is it possible to find directly? Yes.
Yes,
by observing their pattern. That is the benefit of Taylor series. Not to find out all the 100,000, 10,000, 100,000. You just take the derivative 2, 3, 4. And make the pattern, and then you have to predict the nth derivative on the basis of their pattern.
Yes.
Okay, that is the best advantage of Taylor series, because we don't need to find all the derivative. Okay. Okay. Now find what will be the nth derivative of this function. If we find the nth derivative of this function, what happened? Derivative must show their value here, n. And one lesser, n minus 1.
Yes,
then one more lesser, n minus 2. And then goes to their preceding value, 4, 3, 2, 1. And the base function is x minus 1 power, one larger value, in minus n plus 1?
7 minus x.
1 minus x is base function, and in power minus is their base sign, and the derivative is n, then power is 1 larger, 1 plus n plus 1.
With negative sign.
With negative sign. Okay? That is the nth derivative. You can simplify it.
Sir, can you say it's n factorial?
Yes. Yes. You can simplify it as well. If we refine this nth derivative, it's become nth derivative of the function is n n minus 1 n minus 2 till is n factorial. Is it? The whole function should be rewritten as n factorial. It is the summation of all integral values. And now, 1 minus x power minus n plus 1. That is your nth derivative. In first step of the Taylor series, what to do? We have to find the function and all their derivative to form the patterns. In this case, we have calculated all the derivative. In fact, the last derivative. Okay? Now, what will be the next process? Next step, we have to find out the function and their derivative at their function by which the function passes through. That is what? Origin. And after the calculating the function and their derivative at the origin, we have to predict what will be the next position. Either the function increases, decreasing, or static. Okay? The only position of the function should be that is determined as 0 because it is a numeric value. Okay? Now next step, we have to calculate their function and their derivative at their neighborhood function that 0. Okay? Next step. Okay, as we know, step 2, the function f of x, that is what? 1 divided by 1 minus x itself. We have to determine this value at where? At x is equals to 0. If it is x is equals to 0, what happened? 1 divided by 1 minus, if x is 0, it becomes 0. 1 divided by 1 minus 0 is 1, that is 1. Which means the function, if passes through their origin, the value f of y, f of x is what? F of x is nothing but the y. It is the y value of the function. If x is equal to 0, then y is approaches to 1. Okay? That is what? That is point basically. That is what? It is a point. Point of the function that touches to cross. If x is equal to 0, then y is 1. It is a point by which the function should be passes through. Okay? Now, second is, if we plug the first derivative function at 0, x tends to 0, what happened? First derivative of the function is? What is that? See? 1 minus x power minus 1. If we observe, minus 2, if we observe at x is equal to 0, what happened? 1 minus x is 0, power minus 2. 1 minus 0 is 1, 1 power, anything is
1.
1 is equals to 1. What is this? It is the first derivative of the function at x is equals to 0. Clear? Now plug these x is equals to 0 of the third derivative, second derivative as well. Find the second derivative. Static at this point. From 0 to 1, the function, the next function, it is static. Okay? The movement is static. Okay. If we plug f double derivative of x tends to 0, the function is what?
Say 2 times 1 times 1 minus
2 times 1 times 1 minus x is 0 power
minus cube
minus 3. Now, f double derivative of the function at 0 is equals to 2. 1 minus 0 is 1, 1 power anything 1, 1 multiply by 1, 2 ones are 2. Now, which means, now function is increasing. Okay? At a first point, it has static, their neighborhood is static, and after that, function should be increases. by some theta. That is what? That is the rate of change. Okay? Now similarly, if we determine third derivative of the function at 0, 3, 6, 3 into 2, 1 minus 0 power minus 4, 3 2 is a 6. Or we can say it is 3 factorial. Or we can say it is 2 factorial. Or it is what? It is 1 factorial. In terms of pattern recognition, we can say it is factorial sign. Okay? Now in third step, what to do? We have to plug all these function and their derivative at the point 0, that is the origin, substitute, plug in into the formula of the Taylor series to determine the approximate value. Okay? Step 3. According to Taylor series, the formula for the Taylor series is n tends to 0 to infinity, fn of x is equals to what? Function at 0 plus first derivative of the function at 0 multiplied by x divided by 1 factorial plus double derivative of the function at 0 x square divided by 2 factorial and so on. F third derivative of the function at 0 x3 divided by 3 factorial and so on. Does that make sense? It is the formula and we have to pass on all the values and their derivative into the function. Now if we substitute right hand side, what is the function? Function is what? 1 divided by 1 minus x. It is what? It is the sum of the right hand side. If we add up all the values of right hand side, that is what? That is the actual function. 1 divided by 1 minus x, that is the original function. And we wish to predict the neighborhood function. Either total function is 1 divided by 1 minus x. Now what will be the next position? Either the function is static, increasing or decreasing. Okay? Now, first function at 0 is what?
Zero.
We have already calculated. 1 plus function at 0, first derivative of the function at 0 is 1 time of x plus function double derivative of the function 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial into x square. Third derivative of the function at 0, 3 factorial into x cube divided by 3 factorial and so on. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. 1 divided by 1 minus x is equals to 1 plus x, 2 factorial cancel out, x square plus 3 factorial cancel out, x cube plus so on. Now it is the, what? It is the expansion of Taylor series of 1 divided by 1 minus x. In elementary classes, you have done this exercise in terms of geometric progression. As we know, in geometric progression, the sum, because the series is goes to infinity. Infinity, the function has expanded up to infinity. Now, in geometric progression, it is a progression that can progress by multiplying their common ratio. What is the common ratio? That is calculated by second term divided by first term. Second term is x divided by 1, x. Third term divided by second term, x. Fourth term divided by third term, that is x. Which means the common ratio is t2 divided by t1, that is equals to x divided by 1 is equals to x squared divided by x. Both has same value x. The common ratio is a factor that can increase or decrease the function as well as their predicted value. Okay, clear? Now, in elementary classes, you have already studied the sum of the infinite geometric progression is a divided by 1 minus r. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Where a is the first term, r be their common ratio.
Yes, sir.
If you add up right hand side according to their elementary classes, what is, what is it value? A be the first term divide by 1 minus their common ratio is what?
X.
X. C. That is what? Left hand side. We have proved the Taylor series by the elementary class geometry. Clear?
Yes, sir.
The left hand side is equal to right hand side. We have started from left hand side, apply the their function at their origin, their neighborhood function, calculated all the nth derivative, and obtaining the right hand side expanded series, and after that we have adding all the series to produce the left hand side. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now see. Any question?
No, sir.
Okay, now, how to predict this function in real life? Suppose, x is what? X is there? Common ratio. Common ratio is what? It is a factor that can increase the function. Increase or decrease. Which means we are interested to know what is the next point of the function. If function has started from somewhere and goes to somewhere, at the origin we have predicted their value, and x is an integral value that can increases or decreases the function. Okay? What does it mean? It means if we predict the value of x, that is what? That is the derivative. That is the rate of change. Who changes this series? Change occurs due to their value of ratio x. X is their common ratio multiplied by their first term, we have to obtain the second. If that common ratio again multiply the preceding value, x multiplied by x, become x square. If we again multiply x, this series should be progressive. What does it mean? It means the integral value that can change the whole scenario is x. If we predict, suppose x is equal to 0.1, suppose. What is this? Rate of change. This series should be changes as the parameter 0.1. It is the rate of change that influence the series either to increase or decrease. Suppose the temperature of today is 1 unit, then change in temperature should be occurs at the rate of 0.1 factor. Okay, either it should be increases or decreases. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if we substitute this parameter x is equal to 0.1 into the function, what happened? 1 divided by 1 minus 0.1, and this should be expanded on right hand side. 1 plus x, x is what? 0.1 plus 0.1 square plus 0.1 cube and so on. Okay, 1 divided by 1 minus 0.1 is 0.9 is equals to, which means 1 divided by 0.9 is equals to 1.11111 till infinity. If we divide 1 by 0.9, it's become 1.1111 series. It is replica. What is this? It is said to be recurring decimal places, a value that can repeat itself till infinity. Okay? Now, what is the right side? At right side, 1 plus 0.1 should be written 1 by 10?
Yes, sir.
Is it? It is 1 divided by 100? Plus 1 divided by 1000? Next? 1 divided by 10,000? What is this? It is pattern. That is the core idea of the Taylor series, to identify the pattern. Okay, now what is this? If we add up 1, if we approximate the function till 0, it should be equal to 1. And further, if we take the first derivative, the first movement of the function till x is equal to 0.1. What happened? It can predict more accurately that 1.1. If we take the first derivative, function give us the predicted value as 1.1, if we consider two term. And what the influence, what is the effects of the second derivative? It can predict 1.11 more accurately. That is the more accurate prediction. We use Taylor series to make the as possible as good approximation, almost equals to the same. not is equals to 100%, then at least 99.9%. More accurate prediction. If we take the third derivative, that's accurate value up to the 3 decimal place. If we take the fourth derivative, it can predict more accurate value up to the fourth decimal place. And if we take the infinite time, it can predict infinite decimal place prediction. More accurate. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
What is the role of the prediction? We can change the movement, either the function has increasing or decreasing. Now, one more example. If we suppose x is equals to 2, what happened? 2 is what? 2 is the rate of change. If we increase the rate of change as 2, what happened? See. The function is 1 divided by 1 minus x is equals to 1 plus x square and so on. If we plug the value of x is equals to 2 for prediction accurately, what happened? 1 divided by 1 minus 2 is equals to 1, x is 2, 2 square, 2 power 3 and so on. Now 1 divided by 1 minus 1 is minus 1 is equals to 1 plus 2 plus 2 square 4 plus 2 square 8 and so on. Now 1 divided by minus 1 is minus 1 is equals to 1 plus 2 3 3 plus 4 7 7 plus 8 15. Is it? No, it doesn't equal.
Yes, sir.
But on that case it is equal, but in the another case it is not satisfy the left hand side right hand side. Because what is the core idea is we have to predict the function at a smaller level, not the larger. What does it mean? If we see the graph, x is equals to 1, x is equals to 2, which means the function never touches this value. Function never touches this value and goes to infinity. Function changes their path. That is why this point doesn't success by the function. Function doesn't touches this point. X is equals to 2. That is why left hand side, right hand side prediction is inaccurate.
Yes,
which means we have to predict the function as their nearest value, not the larger value. If you want to check either the function is succeeded or not, you have to increase the function as smaller as, like 0.1, you have to check at 0.2. Either the function touches, satisfied, then increase 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, not directly 2. Okay, now another case is if you can check the predicted value at a smaller value and it at larger value doesn't satisfy, which means function doesn't touches that value. Function can change their path before touching that point, approaching that point. Okay, that is the distance. Function doesn't approach x is equals to 2. Okay, now see one more example. Any question?
No, sir.
No. Is that clear? Any question? No question. Okay, see one more example. Okay, if we have a function that is the more easiest function of this world, that is f of x is equals to e power x. It is the simplest function of this world because e power x derivative always be same. How much derivative we have to take? Either we have to take the infinite time nth term, the function remains same derivative. Okay, now we want to what? We wish to find the Taylor series of e power x. As you learned in earlier classes, the Taylor series is of e power x is equals to 1 plus x squared divided by 2 factorial plus x cubed divided by 3 factorial and so on. Okay, but you never prove it because that is the beyond of your syllabus. Now in this course you have to prove it, why it is e power x is equals to 1 plus x square and so on. Okay, you can prove it by the Taylor series. What Taylor series says? In step 1, find the function and all derivative of the function as much as possible. You can do it, and we have to proceed it up to the term where the term of this series can repeat their patterns. We have to observe their pattern. Okay? For example, if the function f of x is equal to e power x, function as it is, if we take the first derivative of the function, e power x remains same. If we take the second derivative of the function, e power x remains same. If the third derivative of the function remains same. Now, what will be the nth derivative of the function? E power x remains same. That's why it's very simple. Okay. Now, after calculating function and their derivative, in second step we have to observe the pattern, the behavior of the function at the origin. If the function can pass on or passes through the origin, what happened? We have to calculate the function and their all derivative at the origin. Next step. What to do? Function at the origin, which means x tends to 0. F of x approaches to 0. E power x. X is 0. E power 0 is 1. F first prime of the function at x is equals to 0. E power 0. Again 1. And f third derivative of the second derivative of the function x tends to 0 is e power 0, that is 1. And till the nth derivative of the function at x tends to 0 is equal to e power 0, that is 1. Now, in third step, we have to plug all the derivatives and their function at the point 0 into the given formula of the Taylor series. Okay, according to Taylor series, f of x is equals to function at 0 plus first derivative of the function at 0 time x divided by 1 factorial plus second derivative of the function at 0 time x squared divided by 2 factorial and so on. Now plug the values. Function at 0 as well as there all the derivatives as much as possible. Now function is what? E power x. That should be expanded on right hand side. Now function at 0, 1. Plus function first derivative at 0 is 1 time of x divided by 1 factorial. That is 1. Function second derivative at 0 is 1 divided by 2 factorial x square and so on. Clear? Now e power x is equal to what? 1 plus x plus 1 by 2 factorial x square. Now the beauty of Taylor series is we have to predict the pattern by taking their derivative. What is the pattern shows? The pattern shows pattern is started from here, x power 1. What is the pattern? Pattern is x power 1 divided by 1 derivative, x power 2 divided by 2 derivative, 2 factorial, x power 3 divided by 3 factorial, and so on till x power 100 divided by 100 factorial. That is the beauty of Taylor series. To pattern recognition, we have to recognize the pattern without taking nth derivative, the derivative at infinite point. We just take the few derivative and we have to recognize the pattern by the Taylor series. Okay, now that is what it is, the exact value 1 plus x plus 1 by 2 factorial x square plus 1 by 3 factorial x cube and so on. That is the series we have already used in earlier classes, but we have used directly, never proof, because that is the beyond your syllabus, beyond your course. Okay, any question?
No, sir.
Thank you. Achha. If you wish to ask any question regarding the today's topic, you welcome. Any questions, confusion?
No, sir.
Do you learn something new?
Yes, sir.
What? One thing is that is common is the geometric series is the extended form of the Taylor series. First thing, that you have already learned in previous classes. And second is prediction, that is you can predict that is a purely field of the probability and statistics. Then we have to predict something by use of calculus according to the Taylor and Maclaurin series. That is the second approach. Okay? And third approach is we can predict something in a smaller rate of change, not a big rate of change. For example, the temperature of today is 40. If we predict there is not a big change, that is not possible, the temperature of tomorrow is 60 degree because there is a big gap. The step size is 20. Is it possible? No.
No, sir.
There is a fluctuation, there is a change in a smaller rate of change. That is a fractional values. That is said to be in derivative delta x. Okay? Thank you.